When it comes to the Warren household, cookies are the sweet of choice, specifically Snickerdoodles. Many places claim to have made the cookie first: Germany, New England, the Pennsylvania Dutch. Wherever they came from, I know one thing: these cookies are soft and buttery, cinnamon sugar coated delicious. I make these from scratch and usually last minute. If you have ever made cookies, a key step is to cream the butter with the sugar. This step gives the cookies their soft texture. Creaming the butter with the sugar requires the butter to be at room temperature and soft, hence my problem. Cold butter is hard, making the creaming process near impossible. So what are my options? Dare the impossible and use rock hard butter? Microwave the butter until it's liquid? Or somehow soften the butter faster without melting it? I'm going to attempt the last option with a hack that has been around for ages. But does it work? And what is the best way to implement it? What is this butter softening hack, you say? Unwrap the butter and place it on the plate. Submerge your glass in hot water for several minutes and allow the glass to heat up. Place the hot glass over the butter and rest it on the plate. Now you wait. This hack obviously works, or this knowledge would not have been passed down through the generations. The question is, can I optimize the method? After all, I can't wait to eat those cookies. As much fun as it would be to make dozens of batches of cookies, the wife would frown on me using all the butter in the fridge. I'm going to employ some technology and virtually simulate the different possibilities. If we follow the scientific method, we need a control to compare to and keep as many of the starting variables the same between experiments. The problem constants are the butter starts with a normal fridge temperature. The glass is heated to 200 degrees, and the room temperature is 73 degrees. The variables include the type of covering container and how the butter is oriented. Three main parts were modeled in SOLIDWORKS to use with flow simulation. The butter is a standard 1/2 cup size, weighing 4 ounces. I could have made a basic model of the containers, but modeling in SOLIDWORKS is so realistic, the glass bowl, and plate take no time at all. Before we jump right into the experiments, a baseline needs to be set, verifying the mechanical properties of the butter. The best course of action is to do a physical test and verify flow simulation matches the control. The control experiment was performed with an ambient room and plate temperature of 73 degrees. The butter started at 41 degrees. A thermal probe was inserted into the butter to monitor the temperature as the butter warms. The goal of the control is a butter temperature of 63 degrees and an understanding of the time it takes to raise the butter to a softened state using just natural convection and the ambient room temperature. This proved to be a long experiment, taking 52 minutes to complete. That's too much time to wait for the butter to warm up. And let's face it, sometimes you just want cookies now. A digital clone was created using the previously modeled parts. Setup was simple inside flow simulation. Materials were assigned, including the important thermal properties. Goals were set to monitor temperature of the butter over time and stop the simulation once an average temperature of the butter reached 63 degrees. Initial temperatures were assigned to the components that matched real-world conditions. Minor adjustments were made to the thermal properties of the butter to match the real-world test. The SOLIDWORKS flow simulation model matched the physical benchmark right on. Flow simulation's correlation provides confidence that the boundary conditions, properties, and assumptions are accurate and can be applied to the faster butter softening possibilities. Based on the items available and the size of the butter, I came up with 4 possible butter softening options. The classic hack of the butter standing vertical with the tall glass covering it. The butter laying down with a glass bowl over top of it. The butter sliced into 10 sections laying on a plate with the bowl. And finally, the butter sliced and stacked vertical with the tall glass covering it. One model was utilized for all the SOLIDWORKS flow simulation runs. Yes, just one model. A configuration was created for each possibility. Because flow simulation is right inside SOLIDWORKS, we can reuse a flow project setup. Cloning the benchmark project to the first possible option transferred all the existing setup. Adding an initial temperature condition to the warm glass and material specification is all that was required for the project. Cloning the first option to each of the remaining possible hacks makes for a quick setup. The batch manager made quick work of running all the projects. Using a 200 degree initial temperature, the glass yielded amazing results. Ranked from the worst to best, the options only vary by minutes. Taking 16 minutes, 12 seconds, the slowest butter softening option was laying the butter down and using a large bowl to cover the plate. Slicing the butter reduced the time by 4 minutes, coming in at 12 minutes, 40 seconds. The flow studies prove the vertical butter orientation is the way to go. Because of the smaller air gap between the butter and glass, the butter warmed faster. Interestingly, the slicing and stacking of the butter warmed slower than the solid stick. Sliced and stacked, the butter took 12 minutes, 20 seconds. The winner, an original old-time suggested hack, is a vertical stick of butter. Getting me baking faster, this winning option takes 10 minutes and 42 seconds. That's a 79% decrease in time to soften over just setting the butter on the counter. What I learned from this exercise is that I wasted time. Better yet, I was able to verify, validate, confirm, and give more confidence to our known hack. SOLIDWORKS Flow Simulation verified this by proving the vertical butter softened fastest. By using a digital clone, SOLIDWORKS Flow Simulation saved me from wishing butter with physical tests. But I still got cookies as for my efforts. Win, win. If you want more information on SOLIDWORKS Flow Simulation, contact Computer Aided Technology. Man, these are good. Reach out to me if you want to copy the Warren Snickerdoodle recipe. I'll see you in the kitchen. It's not a Warren Snickerdoodle without the finishing touch.